Welcome everyone, it's Favors of Dragomar. It's time for some more Raid Shadow Legends. Remember how I said we're gonna fight the traditional termite? Yeah, we're gonna fight the termite. Let's try to fight this. This is gonna be a little challenging because they got a madame. Probably should have went Sanguinia here. But she's still not 60 yet. She's like 30 right now. I'm still planning on putting her in here. Exactly. Okay, that's good. That's massive. Because, yeah, I'm not going to be getting Sanguinia up to par straight away. That's going to take a little bit. So where are we at? We just need one more of those, and then we're gonna just do termite spam, maybe. Let's try this for a laugh. I think I know how this works. Denies you all a possibility of movement. Never taken it. Yeah. That type of team comp, ain't it? Why'd I do that? Let's try to take this shit on. I want to see this. They're faster than us. I Like, this won't be an easy fight, but it'll be easier than the other ones. And we just gotta kill the Rotos. Can we kill the Rotos? That's the question.
Yeah.
Rotos smacks kinda hard. Not gonna be an easy opponent, but at the same time, it's not impossible. Because he ain't optimally built. That's why. Now, I'm gonna be attempting something I haven't tried in a while. So, I'm gonna shove Sanguinia in here. See if she can improve situation now that she is running 6. This does not mean that it's over or that I don't have to get her to 60. That may still be the case. The second that I do that. Yeah, this guy. Mountain King, I think he's called. I think I saw his name a little earlier. This thing is going a little slicker than usual. Buffs onto them is probably better, because they can't take these buffs. I'm not sure. They can't take their own buffs. And we keep everyone alive, which seems to be likely now. I think we can actually beat this godforsaken Stage of Doom. Now, this is going to be very hard, but if we focus that, too preemptively. I had to wait for the BS to land. And it was a good concept, but we still have a ways to go. Mm. Okay, so I made a mistake that cost us that. I'm pretty sure you could see what the mistake was. So I used my other coins too early. We had to use the coins at the right timing. Any mistake you make in this is going to cost you dearly. Their debuffs against them, they struggle. So yeah, that, put up this, put up the holy blood. You want the holy blood, because without the holy blood, you screw. And also, I need to not waste her heal. If I waste, like, because her heals are still a cleanse. If I waste cleanse at the wrong time, it can be curtains. And if you're at all wondering, this was what Sanguinia's purpose was. This is why I bothered. This was why I bothered to get her to 6-star. Because her purpose was to defeat PS like this. That was what her purpose was. Because without her, you get wrecked. This is the preemptive part. I'm not going to use her heal straight away. I know if I use her heal straight away, we won't be able to deal with the impending doom. Especially because that's on cooldown. I think I need to book her. Because, yeah, you can transfer it, but the problem is you gotta do it quick. Seems to be other problems. But, yeah, we're not ready for this, but we've made progress. We've made massive progress. Sanguinia has made some massive progress. It's not perfect, but it's decent. It's decent enough that you can definitely see the difference. You can definitely see the difference between the two. One got wiped before you could ever get to a useful farm. This one makes it all the way in. You can definitely see the difference between the Sanguinia. This one can actually straight up maul this boss and not care. Yeah, there's definitely a difference. There is definitely a difference in power level. Being 6 star is a major difference in power level. You suddenly start to be able to deal with the big boys. You gotta check her bookage as well as continue to improve her gear. Because she's a vital teammate. She stops heinous debuffs. That's her big thing in life, is to stop heinous debuffs. Now, I've done a lot of campaign today. So, I don't really want to do that much more of it, even though I can. I'm gonna go do some clan boss. We're not including her yet, because I want her to be like 6 star for that. Rubbish. Besides, her greatest calling is not clan boss. But she can be used there to decent effect. But her greatest calling is things with a boatload of debuffs. Stuff like Nether Spider. Nether Spider. That rubbish of But yeah. Nether Spider and stuff is her greatest calling. And stuff that does a lot of debuffs. Those crazy enemies. Projectiles. Stuff like that. Things that throw lots of debuffs. That's where she really shines. We're not there yet. We gotta get to that point where she starts really lasting. Give her more levels, more stuff on her gear. She needs to get to that point where she's got like a reliquary tender kind of mad durability. That's the kind of durability you want in someone like that. You want them to stand up. Hell and God. Remove the debuffs. Provide a great deal of power. I smell potential in it. It's there. It's just getting it to work perfectly is another matter entirely. Especially with Taragi getting white. It's basically, in order for that to work, yeah, like, I am seriously considering just a last one. So that the AI is unsure of who to attack next. Or doesn't attack her long enough. To make sure that she both cleanses it and stays alive in expectation if Reliquary has to bring it back. So that's basically the idea. think Thea could benefit from more folks. Burn on you. I remember when Sathya was a true marvel, because before that point, I was the only one that would put the burn on it, on the boss. So it was a marvel. But yeah, I do need to invest in this. In fact, I'm gonna do that just to make sure you wouldn't miss. Having her miss the burn is one of the most painful things to watch you'll ever see. Because in general, you want Sophia to never miss. In fact, I want that so bad, I might actually replace the current view she's got with another I do have to upgrade Sanguinia. Even more, I have to get her to 60. Or as close to it as I can. Give her more stats. Because she's gonna need some stats to get through. Get me wrong, it's just also like Ninja, like a lot of other ninjas, does a lot. Now we got it on fire, that's good. He's getting poisoned. least I'm pissing him off. He's not the best run. Definitely getting under his skin. It's worse. It's 100% worse. But yeah, Sanguinia is not at her final form yet. Final form, which is what she's probably going to need to do in tower. Let's be honest. Because, or at least closer to it, she needs to be close enough that she's on par with the other ones, the other systems. That's the real issue. But she has to be there through hell and thick and thin. Basically, have enough stats that she can just weather the storm. Because it's a storm she has to weather. That's the truth. It's not like I don't play campaign. I do. I just wanted to do it a little quicker. Little twist. We're gonna mixing it up with campaign. So now campaign with a bit of clan boss, a little doom tower attack, stuff like that. I probably have to go farm Griffin instead, though. Yeah, there's a reason. Get Sanguinia up to par was because she's one of the only champions of her kind that exist in the game that are able to truly deny harmful debuffs. And I have to give that gold point where she's strong enough that they can't really affect her that heavily, even if she's kind of put up against the wall. They can't easily do it. That's the thing. You want to make sure that they can't easily take her. Because Sanguinia is going to get focused, because if anyone knows what they're doing, AI or non-AI, they know that if Sanguinia is alive, it's a serious issue. Like, she's getting there, but she's not there. She's 6-star. She's not Omega OP yet. She's gotta get to that specific stage where she's more OP. She's getting to be more OP, but she has to be more OP than that to get past the Doom Tower content. Because as you clearly saw, that Doom Tower content is very savage. Kinda like Arena. But if you don't have a setup near infallible, level gear wise, they will exploit you and blow you to shreds. In a very visceral fashion. One thing that's useful about this character is okay, first things first, before we do that, we gotta check. Yeah. It has to get to that level. Dang. That's a lot of books. Gross. That is a gross amount of books. I gotta say, that is a gross amount of books. To get the cooldown, one down. Takes 6 books of skill. And they're not even rare books, they're legendary. That is kinda repulsive. What's also repulsive is the amount of effort I'm actually having to invest to beat that one stage. And it always comes down to that last thing too. Well, at least the accuracy seems to be fair. Again, accuracy is one of those stats you can't ignore, especially on a team like this, whereby without accuracy, you kind of upgrade. Because you need that accuracy to make sure you get this burn on it. You can't get this burn. kind of want to say, like, you won't be doing proper damage to the bear. Poison and HP burns vital to ruining this boss. So while the weaken is up, it does bonus damage. Save the shield for when he starts. Attack down is pretty good. Burn up. I know this sucker gets to be mad. Alright, we're having a much better run this time. A lot more damage, a lot more burns. With that attack down. And now I think I'll put it up. Ooh, we're landing burns today, boys. I think Sophia's back. I think the Grey Hall has brought Sophia's burns back to the brink. I think that did it. Because I swear she needs that accuracy. Because once she misses that move, like, it takes 6 Lego books to decrease his cooldown by 1. Do you have any idea how hard it is to get Lego books? I have to get the 6 Lego books in each skill and increase it by 1 cool time. Yeah, it's far easier than to do 6 Lego books per crew. Yeah, you're gonna want the attack now. Yeah, this is a decent run. I think having just very high accuracy helps. To make sure whenever she gets her skill off, it burns. It actually does its job. And in general, that makes a world of difference. And it doesn't mean that one day I may not book her out. That day will come. But now, we're not booking her out. Okay then. I nearly killed him. Can we beat what we did last time? question. To land. Ooh, this isn't looking very good. Yeah. As I swear, whenever you miss that, it's a big deal. Man, it's beginning to really hurt. Okay, we got an attack down, but that's not good. At least we got supper. Might even have to go look at his skills. Seriously. Okay, we just smacked both of us. Not the greatest runs. Not the greatest runs. Well, let's see. How does this measure up? Brilliant. Because I still have to get Sanguinia to 6-star. 6-star, excuse me, get that. 60, or close to 60. Closer. Because she's gotta blend in. She's gotta blend in with the rest of them to truly stand out and do a good job. She has to be a hero. In order for her to truly come into her own, she has to to survive the hell where she's actually needed. Because she is needed in a specific form of hell whereby debuffs are so powerful that I need more than Relic Retender to deal with. That's the truth. That's the bitter truth about Sanguinia. Is she's only going to really become special when she has enough stats, levels, etc. to actually fully stand out. Why would I need to buy raid accounts? I already made a new one. Granted, it's a brand new one, so you have to get all the work done, but it's hard work, but if you like the game, it's worth it. But we'll be continuing into Valdemar Strait in the next episode. But before we continue into Valdemar Strait, there is a dungeon we're missing. Remember Fear Knight? Yeah, we gotta do Fear Knight. We have to do at least one tier 9. How about 3 fire knights? I'm saving my burn for the boss. If you're wondering why I use that skill, you need as many multi-hits as you can. You need to wait before the burn to make sure the burn comes, like the shield is completely off him before you do it. Otherwise, he has a major issue with the ones that he did. Just realized someone I could put in this fight that would do her job. Granted, they won't rest, but they'll do their job and get this done a lot quicker. Remember Sanguinia? Yeah, Sanguinia, a lot better for this fight. So yeah, yet another reason to play Sanguinia, if that wasn't already obvious. She even has a triple hit with Fire Knight. So yeah. More reasons to max Sanguinia. It weren't already obvious on how good she is. The debuff removal alone is good enough to want to max her. Never mind the fact she's actually stopping so good boss. In addition to being absolutely important for all content with stupid amount of details. general, the more multi-hits you can get on this guy's shield, the better. And believe me, when I say anything that hits multiple is good for this boss. Because the more times it hits multiple, the better. Now, I'm gonna do this version, and I'm not gonna be a dumb nut bar and put that in, because I know that Sanguinia is standing down the boss. Instant shield removal. Try that out. I'm glad he's not like the magma dragon, because then he would heal from that. See, better than Reliquary Tender for this boss, because guess what? Multi-hits. He doesn't just block the debuffs, he multi-hits. Granted, she can't revive. Urgent dies. Pretty solid. Solid champion. See? I completely changed my rank. Gotta do at least one of these. Oh yeah, killed Sniper, but it's for the best. It's for the best. I needed that cleanser in, let's be honest. She's still not in her final form, but I don't care. I needed her. Without that. That.